The Seal River Watershed is a pristine place that encompasses 50,000 square kilometers in northern Manitoba.
You always know that there's an abundance of birds in the watershed. You hear the birds in the morning and in the evening squawking at you and laughing at you. Our nations who carry this information should be thought of as true experts. So in 2020, Audubon Society approached us to help them with bird monitoring in the watershed, letting us have say and control in how we're going to collect the information and sending out our own peoples to do the research out in our own backyard. Whereas in the past, it's always been outsiders come in, not tell us what was going on, what was the significance of the work they were doing. We so appreciate being able to work together like this in partnership.
So this year I mentioned to Jeff at Audubon that, you know, it'd be really amazing to get some more devices and put them up in the watershed before the ice melts.
We consulted with some of the elders and thinking about the differences in the habitat and what kind of birds might be using the different berries and the different types of foliage. Wanting to make sure that we had a variety of different places so that we could hopefully pull in more different species.
Before the devices, we're just right in the core of the heart of the watershed. So now we're trying to expand that because it's such a large space, right? It's a big area of land. We're hoping to get these to other community reps in hopefully Northlands and in Barrenlands, maybe one or two sent to Arbiet to get some installed right in the northern part of the watershed to get even more recording happening. Jeff just sent me an email of a picture of the devices that will be arriving tomorrow. You just have to basically install the chips, which is amazing because you can analyze faster. By installing these, we know more about the birds and their migration routes. We know how far some of the birds are traveling to get to this pristine land. And we know more space that we need to protect.
Working with Jeff Wells and the Audubon Society has been refreshing. They've been so open and understanding and really truly been allies to the work that we've been doing. There are so many situations in the past where the science community did not look to the Indigenous communities for this support and had a lot of gaps in the information that they carried and they had because they weren't asking us.
Like that we have chickadees in the watershed, which our families have known forever, but lots of people in the science world were saying, we don't know if they go that far north. I'm named after a chickadee in Dene. And scientists were saying there's no chickadees. Well, after last year, we know there are chickadees in the watershed because we have them in the recordings.
Collecting this information really helps us make decisions on how we want to conserve and protect the watershed, utilizing the Indigenous knowledge, but also Western science to have 2 feet planted in a world. The opportunity to work together and partner. It's a step in the right direction. It's really exciting. It's really exciting and it really does feel like at the end of the day, I close my eyes and I'm happy because I think that it's worth it in the end.